As we have seen throughout my video series, and as I'm sure any unbiased YouTube user will verify, propagandists have a bad habit of going out of their way to make their opponents look bad by any means possible. It doesn't even necessarily have to have anything to do with the moon landings. If it's a simple typo, mispronunciation, honest oversight, anything, they'll hold it against you as though it undermines everything you've ever said and never let you hear the end of it. Even after you've rectified these mistakes, they absolutely will not let it go. In addition, they'll use every logical fallacy in the book, straw men, guilt by association, and above all, quote mining. In addition to his White Noise series, AstroBrant 2 has another video series called The Anatomy of a Conspiracy Theorist, in which he tries to pin so-called foibles on his opponents. His first video, which is hate-themed, basically flashes through various offensive messages posted by YouTube user Human Monkey Race. These obnoxious comments are not endorsed by myself and certain other moon hoax conspiracy theorists who shall remain nameless, but AstroBrant felt fit to imply that this behaviour is typical of moon hoaxes in general.
Conspiracy theorists generally seem to be angry, emotionally dysfunctional people who are just going out there looking for something to be angry at. If it wasn't this, it would be something else. People like this need to take a serious look at themselves, their personality, their interaction with other people, and perhaps consider getting some professional help.
His next video in this series focuses on paranoia, another trait that he tries to pin on conspiracy theorists in general by any means possible.
Now then, Dimitri, you know how we've always talked about the possibility of something going wrong with the bomb. The bomb, Dimitri. The hydrogen bomb. Well, now, what happened is one of our base commanders, he had a sort of, well, he went a little funny in the head. You know, just a little funny. And he went and did a silly thing. Well, I'll tell you what he did. He ordered his planes to attack your country. Well, let me finish, Dimitri. Let me finish, Dimitri.
Yes, Brigadier General Ripper, played masterfully by Sterling Hayden, did have a little bit of a problem. He went a little funny in the head. He was paranoid. He was a conspiracy theorist, and he finally went full-blown psychotic and launched an air attack against the Soviet Union, locking himself inside his post and waiting for the imminent attack by American soldiers to try to bring back the bombers.
I can no longer sit back and allow communist infiltration, communist indoctrination, communist subversion, and the international communist conspiracy to sap and impurify all of our precious bodily fluids.
General Ripper was a fictional character, but this man wasn't. This is Ralph René. He said we never went to the moon and spent most of his adult life disparaging that achievement.
Most of his adult life is a bit of an exaggeration. Technically, you become an adult when you reach the age of 18. René was 57 when he first started doubting NASA in 1990, and he was 75 when he died. That means he only spent 18 years of his adult life believing the Apollo missions were faked. 18 years out of his 57 years of adulthood hardly constitutes to being most of his adult life.
And spent most of his adult life disparaging that achievement and all the people involved with it.
Not all the people involved with it. In his book, he clearly states that he believed the Earth orbit flights of Apollos 7 and 9 were real, and kindly spares those involved of the astronaut status that he awarded to moonwalkers and certain Gemini astronauts.
And he was every bit as psychotic as Ripper's character. But René got most of his ideas from this man, Bill Kaysing.
No, he didn't. Astrobrand has made it clear that he hasn't read either book by these men. If you're going to admit that you haven't read the book you are attacking, you shouldn't proclaim yourself to be an expert on it. This is the second time that Astrobrand has claimed René got most of his ideas from Bill Kaysing.
Borrowing heavily from Bill Kaysing's book, titled We Never Went to the Moon, René's plastic ring-bound pamphlet also claimed the NASA moon missions were all staged on Earth.
In actuality, the only things René borrowed from Kaysing's book were two photographic anomalies, one footnote, and some passing mentions of the things Kaysing uncovered during his time at Rocketdyne. That's it. The rest of René's book is all his own material, which he learned by religiously reading countless books by various scientists and astronauts involved in Apollo or other NASA projects, or astronomers and historians that can be considered an authority on this subject. Kaysing himself even stated that René's book was superior to his own.
There's a new book out, NASA Mooned America.
Yes, that's by a man named Ralph René, who lives in Passaic, New Jersey, and the book is very well done. It's far superior to my book, because René is essentially a self-taught engineer, and he's come up with a lot of important points that I missed completely.
Astrobrand must surely know this, because Kaysing said that, right at the beginning of the interview, that Astrobrand likes to mine for quotes.
In most of what he says and writes, you can see his hatred of the American government and his distrust for organizations and institutions.
Which writings? Kaysing's writings are by far some of the most polite that I've ever read. And even when he expresses things that upset him, or annoy him, or stuff he doesn't like in general, he expresses his views in a very calm and civilized manner.
He lived in a trailer out in the desert with his entourage of cats.
And what's wrong with that? Kaysing loved the desert and scenery in general, and was always there to help his fellow man. After his wife Ruth died, Kaysing devoted the rest of his life to helping his friend Sylvia Liss run her mobile cat sanctuary.
And wouldn't eat meat bought in American markets.
Can you blame him? Do the words supersize me or fast food nation ring any bells to Astrobrand too? Most people I know worry about putting on weight when they travel to America. But during my visit, I actually lost 2 kilograms. Not because the US is a buffet of health food, but rather because the meat and food in general was so revolting that I often skipped meals. Maybe I was eating at the wrong place, but from my experience, anything marginally edible in the States is a surprise.
He was a full-blown paranoid psychotic, just like General Ripper. He had an undergraduate degree in English and went to work for Rocketdyne, which was associated with NASA, working in their publications department. He left Rocketdyne 3 years before the beginning of the Apollo program.
You can tell he's getting this from Jay Windley's baseless page on Bill Kaysing, can't you? Anyways, Kaysing worked at Rocketdyne between the years of 1956 and 1963. The Apollo project began in 1961. Further, by the time Kaysing joined Rocketdyne, they had already begun work on various engines which they would later supply on Apollo, like the F1 and H1 engines used on the Saturn V and Saturn I respectively. Later, during his career in 1960, he saw the development of the J2 engine begin, and towards the end of his career, he saw various breakthroughs flourish, such as Project First, a program initiated in 1962 to try and overcome the F1's combustion instability problems.